Today we'll be reviewing the MOTO100 Diagnostic Scan Tool because as motorcycles get more and more dependent on sensors and technology than ever before, this kind of thing is going to be coming more and more handy even just among motorcycle DIYers like me and maybe like you as well. So we'll be looking at what this thing can actually do and whether or not you need to buy one because it is a serious tool, but at around $500-$550 US, it also comes with a serious price tag. I'm Adrian from YouMotorcycle. I make videos for people who want to learn about motorcycling. And when the makers of Moto 100 reached out to me and asked me if I wanted to review one of these things, I was like, heck yes, give me that because I make a lot of how-to videos and this thing just seems like right up my alley. So as I was waiting for it to arrive, I started looking at all the different other reviews that were already on YouTube for the thing. And I noticed that all of the reviewers on YouTube were making a lot of really big claims about all of the stuff that this thing could do. The YouTubers told me that this thing could test coils, controls, pumps, solenoid sensors, fans, valves, fuel pumps, injectors, brakes, traction control, actuators, you name it. It sounded too good to be true. And when something sounds too good to be true, well, you know. So have we actually entered the era of the universal motorcycle diagnostic tool? Is this the bandwagon we should all be hitching our horses to? Or are those other YouTube reviewers just totally full of horseshit? Let's find out. I wanted my review to be different because all those other ones seem to follow the same format of, I'm gonna show you how to register an account, I'm gonna show you how to first log in, and stuff that you don't need to know. This thing is really simple to use. What you need to know is actually how well does it really work? So that's what we're gonna be covering. Instead of my original plan, which was to take a look at some of these bold claims that the other YouTubers were making and then just challenge their claims, what I realized was that's not gonna necessarily help you or me who are more like the average motorcyclist. Like, when's the last time I had to actuate anything on my motorcycle to test it? Our bikes are fairly reliable these days. Why don't I pick three or four things that the average motorcyclist might be more likely to face because it's better value as content for you guys to see. So hopefully what I'm gonna show you makes more sense. The four things that we'll be testing are a lot more basic because, like I said, it's what you and I are more likely to actually use this tool for. So the first true to life simulation that we'll be kind of doing is just very basic, plug it in and let's make sure it can actually read the mileage accurately. Just kind of simulate maybe you or I are buying a used motorcycle. We want to make sure that the seller is being really honest with us. Let's plug that in. The second thing that we're going to be testing is if there is an engine light on a motorcycle, because I have one of my bikes has one. Can we read what the error code is first, pretend like we've done whatever we need to do to fix it, reset the light, and then see if it comes back, and then by that way know that we did or did not fix the problem. The third thing we'll be testing is, can we activate the ABS pump? Because you should be changing your brake fluid every 2 years. I have a ton of content on how to tell if your ABS fluid needs to be replaced, yada, yada, yada. I'll link to them up around there somewhere. You need to do this every 2 years if you want to have really good braking, and braking is so, so important on a motorcycle. When you have a motorcycle with ABS, you need to activate the ABS pump to really let all of the old fluid out. I'm really hoping that this machine can do that. And last but not least, we're gonna try to activate the fan and activate the thermostat. And this is to test the cooling system. Again, this is to simulate if we are looking to buy a used motorcycle. Has the cooling system been working? Is there a risk that this bike has had overheating issues? Or if you're right about to leave on a motorcycle road trip, somewhere hot, you wanna make sure that your bike is up to snuff, it's a good idea to check your cooling system before you go. So on the surface, compared to all the advanced stuff that all the other motorcycle YouTubers said that this thing could do, my stuff's pretty simple. So let's see how the Moto 100 does in our tests. In order to get data from as many motorcycles as I could, I didn't test this on just one bike. I tested this on all three of my motorcycles that it was compatible with. We'll talk about compatibility in just a second. The first bike that we tested on is gonna be my BMW F700 GS, it's 2014. Then my 2011 BMW G650 GS, and then my 2009 Triumph Bonneville SE. All right, so finally, let's talk about what's important. How did this thing do? On the very first test on my BMW F700 GS, I plugged it in and right away it told me what the actual real mileage was and it matched my odometer, so I was very happy with that. However, I was not able to activate my ABS pump. I was not able to activate my thermostat. I was not able to activate my fan. So it failed all of those tests. And the one I was most disappointed about was this was a bike that had a check engine light on. And that was for a routine service reminder. I was not able to reset that reminder and make it go away. So I'm gonna need a proper dealer tool most likely, or a better tool than this to reset that light. That's very annoying. Out of the four things I tested, it only passed one test. When I plugged in my BMW G650 GS, the second bike, It told me not the mileage, but how many run hours were on the motor, so I'll give it a half point for that. Now, there was no check engine light on this bike for me to check or reset, so I couldn't test that. Also, this bike does not have ABS, so I couldn't test that either. The bike does have a fan and thermostat, and the Moto 100 could not activate those functions. So overall, I could only test two functions on the BMW G650 GS, and this tool got a half point out of two. And the last bike, of course, is my Triumph Bonneville. Now, this bike does not have ABS, it's not liquid cooled, so there was a bunch of stuff I couldn't test, there was no check engine lights. The only thing I could test was, can I plug it in and check mileage? And I really want to check the mileage on this Triumph because it almost looks like someone's been into my Triumph Speedo before. Of the four things I wanted to test, I could only test one, and it got 0 out of 1. And they do make two different versions of the Moto 100. The first one is the European version, that's what I got. And then they also have a American version, which is like for Harley, Indian, Polaris, Victory. I have a full detailed review of this on YouMotorcycle.com. I'll link to it in the description box as well. So basically I did 7 tests across 3 different bikes with my Moto 100 and its final score was like 1.5 out of 7. Really all it did was tell me what the mileage was on one bike and how many hours were run on the other. So even between the same brand, there's a lot of variance in what you can and can't do and access with this thing. And I guess that means it's sort of, you know, in conclusion, whether it's Santa Claus, the Tooth Fairy, the Easter Bunny, or the YouTuber who told you that this product is great and you should buy it, that's just a list of people you probably should not trust to believe in. Do I think that there are people who should and shouldn't buy this product? Yeah, absolutely. I think if you're a new motorcyclist, if you're tight on cash, you have a carbureted, very simple, basic motorcycle, don't buy this, save your money. If you are someone like me, that's where things might get a little different. If you're somebody who has a bunch of different motorcycles, if you're somebody who has friends whose motorcycles you are the guy that they come to, like, please help me, this might actually be a good purchase. I didn't pay the full price. I only paid about $100 in duties to get this brought into the country. I think all the YouTubers are recommending it because on that $500 purchase, they got like 4%. They're making like 20, 22 bucks, depending on what the sale price is that week, recommending you buy this. And for some of you, it's gonna be absolutely amazing. I suspect if you have newer motorcycles than mine, where the most recent I have is 2014, you'll probably be able to do a lot more with this than I could. I suspect if you're much more mechanically savvy than me and you wanna just look at all of the data as opposed to just try and make basic stuff happen, this could be really good for you, especially if you are having some kind of really weird issue with your motorcycle, firing engine order, that sort of thing. This is awesome. But it's not going to be for everybody. So I will put a affiliate link. My strong suggestion, if you are somebody who have multiple bikes, you do think some kind of diagnostic tool might be very valuable for you and could pay for itself, because if you can just activate the ABS pump and bleed the brakes on all your bikes yourself, totally this is going to pay for itself in no time. I suggest buying it from Amazon specifically because, no, not because of the commission, because you have 30 days to return it. And I suggest try it straight away. I don't want you thinking that I'm recommending stuff to you guys that is no good for you and then it sits on your shelf and you're like, I spent $500 because that Adrian told me to buy it. It's super easy to use this device. You plug and play. There's a couple cool features I really like in here. Like, it'll show you a diagram of where the diagnostic connector is on every single motorcycle. So it's very easy to know where to plug it into. It's super easy to use, but it's not gonna be for everybody and it is a ton of money. So I don't recommend you buy it just willy-nilly. And if you do buy it, I think it could be a major, really good tool for you. Just remember, free returns, buy it, test it. If it's not doing a lot for you, just make sure you get your money back, all right? Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please do me a solid. Hit the like button, lets me know my content is helping people. Lets me know you guys appreciate honest motorcycle content and encourages me to make more videos aimed at helping motorcyclists. My name is Adrian. Ride safe, but have fun. Peace.